we are going to study the remaining part of the chapter number 9. The chapter name is the living organisms, characteristics and habitats. Class 6, subject science and CERT. In the previous videos of this chapter, in the first we had seen that there is no place on the earth where the living organisms are not there. That means say, everywhere on the earth the living organisms are present. Then after, we have seen the organisms and the surroundings where they are living. That means, the different types of surrounding has the different kinds of organisms, either plants or animals. And we have seen some examples also, that is about mountains, then after aquatic habitats like rivers, ponds, ocean, etc. Next, we have seen about habitat and adaptation. What is habitat and what is adaptation? So, in that we have seen that the place where these living organisms or these organisms are living is known as the habitat, and the adaptations, that means the some special features or you can say characteristics which are adapted by the animals to survive in such kind of environment or surrounding. So that is known as the adaptation. Then after we had seen some of the objects, animals and plants found in the different habitats or in the different surroundings, like the forest, in mountains, on the mountains, and after in the desert, in the sea, or if you had visited any other place, then at that place. The next we had seen, this we had discussed about habitat. So here it is aquatic habitat is there, and that one is the desert habitat is there, or you can say terrestrial habitat is there. And from that we have seen that there are major two types of habitats are there, that is terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. That means the surrounding in which the animals or plants or organism, you can see, they are living on the land. So such kind of environment or surrounding is known as the terrestrial habitat. And here it is given to you about aquatic habitats. So the animals or plants that live in water, so they are said to be living in the aquatic habitats. The examples also we had seen about terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitats. So here, then after we had discussed deeply in about terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitats. So in the terrestrial habitat, first we had seen about deserts. What kind of organisms, what you can say, what kind of life is there in the deserts? It is about plants and animals also. So in that we had seen about rat and snakes. The next terrestrial habitat we had seen, that was mountain regions. Which kind of animals or trees or plants are found on the mountains? So this one we had seen about plant, and this one we had seen about the animals. The next we had seen that is about grassland. What kind of animals are found in the grasslands? Grassland is also a kind of terrestrial habitat. So in that we had seen about lion and deer. What are the adaptations of lion and deer to survive in the grasslands? Next we had seen about aquatic habitat. In the first one we had seen about oceans. Which kind of animals and plants are found in the oceans? What is their adaptations? Next we had seen about ponds and lakes. Same like the oceans, which kind of animals and plants are found in that, and what kind of adaptations they had adapted to survive in the that particular habitat. Next we had seen that characteristics of organisms. We know that some around us, some of the things are living while some of the things are not living. So now how we can classify or how we can differentiate these living things from non-living things, we have seen some examples that we are saying that the living things are moving. So car and buses, or you can say bike, are moving, but we are considering them as non-living. Or trees are not moving, or they cannot move from one place to another place. However, we are considering them the living things. So what kind of characteristics does living things and non-living things possesses? So that we are going to study in this video. In that first characteristics is about food. That do all living organisms need food? The first characteristics. So in chapter 1 and 2 we have learned that the living things need food and it is essential for animals, or you can say all the living things, to take the food. Why? Because we have learned that from the food we are getting the energy. Like us organism, or you can say animals or human beings, plants also require the food, and they are making their food by their own, by the process of photosynthesis. They are making their own food by the process of photosynthesis, and they are using in that sunlight, then after carbon dioxide, etc. Then now animals, how they are taking the food? So they are depending on the plants and other animals for their food. Now here it is given to you why we are taking the food, or what is the requirement of food. So food gives us organism, or food gives us energy which is needed for them to grow. Organisms also need energy for the other life processes that are going inside them. We are performing various kind of functions like reading, playing, then after writing, sleeping, even sleeping also we require the energy. So to perform these kind of various functions we need the energy. So now from where we are getting this energy? So we are getting the energy from the food which we are taking. So that's why all the living organisms need the food. So this one is the first characteristic, that organisms need food. Now next characteristic is, do all organisms show the growth? First we have seen that is food. Next is growth. Does all the living organisms show the growth? So now let me see that all the organisms are showing growth or not. So here one example is given to you, that does the kurta you had purchased or you had bought 4 years back still fit you? The kurta or the clothes which you had purchased before the 4 years or even before the 2 years, does it fit for you right now? So you cannot wear it anymore. You cannot wear that after 3 to 4 years. Why? Because our height increases, our weight increases. So that's why we cannot wear the same kurta after the 4 to 5 years. So we can say that you must have grown taller during these years, and you may not realize it, but you are growing all the time, and in few more years you will become an adult. You will not realize that you are growing or your height is increasing, but you are growing and your height is continuously increasing during these years. So after the 4 to 5 years the same kurta or the same outfit will not fit you, and after the few years you will become an adult. That means you are growing. Same like now, as human being, the animals also grow into the adults, or they are showing the growth. How? So let me see the examples. You might have seen the puppy grow into the adults. The puppy or the dog you might have seen grow into the adult, or a chick which is hatched from an egg grows into a hen or a cock. The egg, or you can say chick, is growing into the hen or cock, and puppy of the dog is growing into the adult dog. So that means they are also showing the growth. The like, now next about plants. We have seen about human beings, animals. Now what about the plants? So plants also grow. For that, look around you and see a few plants which has the particular type, and some are very small, young, and some are bigger. You will find that some plants are very small and some plants are bigger. So now they may have been in different stages of their growth. You can say that their size is different. So they are in different stage of growing. And look at the plants after few days and few weeks. You will find that their height is increasing. That means they are showing the growth. They will get the more leaves or branches. So we can say that they are growing day by day. You may find that some of them have grown in the size, and growth seems to be common to all living things. So that's why we can say that the growth is common to all the living things. That means the second characteristics of living things is growth. They are showing the growth. Now do you think that no living thing shows growth? Think about this. No, you will not find that non-living things are growing. Like take an example of chair. Observe the chair after the 15 days. Again observe the same chair. Did you find that the chair is growing, the bigger size, as the size of the chair is larger, it becomes larger? No. No, you will not find the difference in the size of the non-living things. So we can say that the non-living things are not showing the growth. So this is the second characteristics of living organisms. Now moving on the next characteristics of this living organism, that is about respiration. Do all living organisms respire? So before that, let me see what is respiration. So now you are inhaling some air and exhaling some air. That means breathing. So now can you think about this? Can you live without breathing or hold your nose and mouth at once? With both, hold this both at the time. So will you find that for how long you can able to hold this both at a time? For no longer, not more than 1 minute. So that means we cannot live without breathing. So when we inhale the air, so it air during this process, the air moves out from outside to inside in our body. And when we breathe out the air, so at that time, air moves from inside from our body to the outside. That means we are taking in air and then after we are exhaling or we are removing that air from our body. So that is known as the breathing, and the breathing process is a part of a respiration. This breathing is a part of a process, different process is known as the respiration. So now in the respiration, some of the oxygen which is present in the air, we are taking in or we are breathing and it is used by our body. And we breathe out carbon dioxide produced in this process. During this respiration process, the oxygen which we are taking, that is utilized to release the energy or to make the energy, and as a result, the carbon dioxide gas is produced, and this gas is produced during this respiration process, and we are releasing or we are breathing out this gas from our body. So the process of breathing in animals like cows, buffaloes, dogs, or cats are similar to us, that means be similar to humans. Now, if you want to find out how they are breathing, then observe any of these animals while they are resting, while they are taking the rest, and notice the movement of their abdomen, or you can say their body, while they are taking the rest. The movement of their abdomen will show that they are breathing. That means the animals are breathing, that means all the living organisms are breathing. So this is about human beings and animals. Now what about the plants? So now let me see. So respiration is necessary for the all the living organisms. We have seen about plant, animals and human beings. So it is necessary for all the living organisms. It is through respiration that the body finally obtains energy from the food it takes. We had discussed that during this respiration, energy is released or energy is brought down from the food. We are getting energy from the food during this process of respiration. So that means to get the energy, all living organisms need to respire, or respiration is necessary. That means this one is the third characteristics of living thing, that is respire. Some animals may have different mechanisms for exchange of these gases, which is a part of the respiration process. We have seen that the respiration process is the part of in which one other process is there, which is known as the breathing. And in that process, the exchange of gases take place. So different animals have the different kinds of this respiration process or breathing process, different, they have the different mechanism or different method for this respiration. Here some examples are given to you. That one, first one is about given to you, that is earthworm. So earthworms breathe through their skin. They are breathing through their skin. They have this slimy skin. So they are taking in air, or they are taking out the air, throwing out the air through their skin. The next example is about fish. We learned that the fishes has the gills. So how they are useful for exchange of gas? So they, these gills have the blood vessels, and those blood vessels help them to take in air or to throw out the air. So that means the gills are useful for the exchange of gases. These gills are used for to take the oxygen which is dissolved in water. So the gills absorb the oxygen from the air dissolve in the water. The oxygen is dissolved in the water, and from that water they are absorbing the oxygen. So this is how the fish and silkworms shows the breathing, or you can say respiration. Now what about the plants? Do you think that plants also respire? So the exchange of gases in plants mainly take place through the leaves. This process is take place in the plants through their leaves. So the leaves take in air through the tiny pores in them and use their oxygen to release the energy. This respiration process is performed mainly by the leaves. So now how these leaves are taking or they are exchanging the gas? So leaves has the tiny pores, or you can say small holes, which is helpful to them in transfer, or you can say exchange of gases. These tiny pores are known as the stomata. They give out carbon dioxide to the air, and the same like the human plants also taking in the oxygen, and they throw out, or you can say they give out carbon dioxide into the air. So like animals and other organisms, plants also respire. So now you might have the question that some of you may heard that plants are taking carbon dioxide and they are releasing the oxygen. But here the different thing is given to you that plants are also like the animals, they are taking oxygen and they are releasing the carbon dioxide. So what is the right thing? So we have learned that in sunlight, plants use carbon dioxide to produce food and give out the oxygen. This is the different process that is known as the photosynthesis. In that the plants use the sunlight and as a result, and also carbon dioxide, and as a result they are producing the food and they are releasing the oxygen in the air. But in the respiration they are taking in oxygen and they are releasing the carbon dioxide. So the amount of oxygen which is released by them in the process of the food preparation, or you can say in the process of photosynthesis by plants, is much more than the oxygen that is used in the respiration. That means they are releasing more amount of oxygen as compared to their using the oxygen from the air. So that's why we are saying that the plants are releasing oxygen in the air and they are taking carbon dioxide from the air. So respiration in plants take place day and night. So this can be asked that the photosynthesis process or the food preparation process in the plants, it takes place during the daytime only, because during the daytime only the sun is there or sunlight is available. But the respiration process in the plants, it takes place during the daytime as well as in the nighttime also. So this is the third characteristics of living organism or living things, that is the living things respire. Now next characteristics, that is fourth number, do all organisms respond to stimuli? So now before going on, what is the stimuli that we will see? So how do you respond? Some conditions are given to you. You have to think about how will you respond to these situations. So how do you respond? If you suddenly step on these sharp objects like a thorn while walking on the barefoot. If you are going on barefoot on somewhere, then if your feet step on the sharp object like the thorn, then how will you respond? You will suddenly take your, or you will quickly take your leg apart. So this is your response. Then another situation is, how do you feel when you see or think about your favorite food? If you will think about your favorite food, then how will you feel? Your mouth start watering. So this will, this is how you will respond this respond to this situation. Then you suddenly move from a dark place into a bright sunlight. If you are going into the bright sunlight from the dark place suddenly, then how will you face this situation? So your eyes shut themselves automatically for a moment till they adjust to the bright sunlight. Your eyes will adjust itself to face the bright sunlight. So this is how your eyes will respond to this situation. So now some of these changes, that is your favorite food, thinking about your favorite food, then after going into the bright light and walking on a thorn. So in all these situations are some of the examples of changes which are taking place in our surroundings. changes in our surrounding that make us to respond them, that is known as the stimuli. This means to react something, to react towards something or some situation. That means we have the feelings. You can say that the living organisms has the feelings, that is stimuli. To response or to respond to the changes which are taking place in our surrounding is known as the stimuli. So now that is about us, that means human being. So now what about the other animals? Do all the other animals also respond to this stimuli or this kind of changes? So observe the behavior of the animals. Like when food is served to them, do you find that suddenly they are becoming active on seeing that food? You will find that if you are giving a roti or chapati to a cow, so they will suddenly come towards you. So that means they are responding to this stimuli. When you move towards a bird, what does it do? If bird is there somewhere and if you are going towards that bird, then it will fly away. So it means the birds also shows this stimuli. Now wild animals run away from the when the bright light is flashed towards them. We know that the wild animals cannot come or they are not coming towards the bright light. So that means they are showing the stimuli towards this bright light. Next is similarly cockroaches begins to move to their hiding place if the light in the kitchen is switched on at the night. If you had switched on the lights at the night of the kitchen, then the cockroaches, you will find that the cockroaches are hiding at some place. So that means they are also showing the stimuli. So now, can you give some more examples of this responding of animals to this stimuli? So you can think about this. All the animals are showing this stimuli towards certain changes. Or they are responding to these changes. Some of the examples are given here about animals. Now what about the plants? Do they also show the stimuli or response to stimuli? So do plants also respond to stimuli? Flowers of some plants, if you had heard about this or you had seen that, flowers of some plants bloom only at night. And we know this, one of the example also we know that. In our language we are saying it Ratrani. The flower of this plant Ratrani, it blows only on the night time. So they are showing this stimuli or they are showing the response towards this close after sunset. Some plants closes its flowers. In some other plants like mimosa or which is commonly known as the touch me not plant. So they leaves the leaves of this plant close or cold when someone touches them. In mimosa or touch me not plant, if we are touching the leaves of that plant, then it will fold or you can say it will close the leaves. So that means they are showing the response to the stimuli, and these are some examples of responses of plants towards the changes in their surrounding. These are the responses to the plants to their surrounding, that is respond to stimuli. Other than that, we also know that sunflower moves its directions towards the direction of the sun. That means the sunflower shows the stimuli, response to stimuli. That means the stimuli, which stimuli is that? The change in the direction of the sun. So they are also showing the response. So the four characteristics of living things is respond to stimuli or respond to changes which are taking place in our surrounding. Here to prove this, one activity is given to you, that is activity number 4. This activity you have to perform with a plant, with a potted plant. So for that you have to place a potted plant in a room a little away from a window through which sunlight enters sometimes during the day. In a room a little away from the window you have to put a potted plant where such place that it will get the sunlight for some time of the day. And then after you have to continue watering the plants for a few days. And then you have to observe that does the plant grow upright like the plants which is there outside the room. And you have to note the direction in which this plant is bent. And if it is not growing upright, So, do you think that this may be response to some stimulus? Here in the figure it shows to you. Here you can see that the window is there and plant is put or leave some little space away from the window, so it will get the sunlight for some time of the day. So now, does this plant will grow upright, that means in straight direction, or it will bend? So you will, after performing the activity, if you will perform this activity, you will find that after some days this plant, here you can see that it will grow or it will bend towards the sunlight. From where it gets the sunlight, this is getting sunlight from here, so the plant will bend towards that side. So that means they are showing the response to the stimuli, that means they are showing the response to the sunlight. So we can say that all living things respond to changes around them. The changes which are taking place around them, they are showing the stimuli or they are showing the response. So these four characteristics we have seen, that is, first we have seen about food, that all living things need the food, either it's an animal, plants or other animals or human being. The next characteristic that we had seen about growth, that all the living things shows the growth. They show the growth, so that's why their height will increase, their body shape will change, or somewhat they are showing the growth. Next we had seen that respire. All the living organisms respire. All the living organisms need energy, and they are getting this energy from the food that which they are eating. So, to break down of that food into the energy, they are respire or they are performing the respiration. Next, fourth number characteristic, we have seen that respond to stimuli. That means all the living organisms are responding to the stimuli, or you can say the changes which are taking place in surrounding them. So, these four characteristics of living things we have seen in this video. The remaining characteristics of the living organisms or living things which differentiate the living things from the non-living things, we will study in the next video.